I'm in San Francisco.
I've already been here for a few days, but I haven't really had a lot of time to myself until right now, so I thought I would just do a quick little update. As per usual, this vlog is probably going to be extremely scattered and disjointed because I have not been doing a very good job at filming. I guess I'll kind of explain and go into why it's been so disjointed. Basically, I've been spending a lot of time with friends and this guy I've been seeing, and overall it just like doesn't really feel like a good time to whip out the camera and like throw a camera in people's faces if they're not comfortable with it. And I've mainly just been wanting to like enjoy the time with them. Overall, my general opinion of SF is that it's fucking beautiful. The weather has been amazing ever since I've been here, but I can't really tell if that's just because like I came directly from New York to SF and New York was getting so cold when I left. But so far it's been really clear, it's been beautiful, everyone's been really friendly, and I've been enjoying myself. I think tonight the person I'm seeing is going to be, I think we're going on like a driverless ride. I don't really know what that is. I don't think anything like that is being rolled out in Vancouver, so I don't really know what to expect, but like we'll see, it could be fun. And then I think we're going somewhere else, I can't remember.
To be honest, I'm really just trying to figure out what I'm doing with this guy I'm seeing. I want to think things through, I want to make sure I make the right decision, and I don't want to overcomplicate my life, but I also don't want to miss out on anything that could be super special. So that's where I'm at. I will probably do a video at some point that sums up more of my feelings on this.
Catching up with high school friends has been really fun. It's really interesting to see how some people have grown and some people haven't grown. I don't know, it's so weird because, you know, like at this point I've known some of these people for like 10 years, and you don't realize how much people are changing until you like take a step back. That's been really fun and interesting to see. I'm really proud of them for how they've grown.
I just went to Boudin and got a baby turtle bread. Fun fact, the first time I went to Boudin when I was really, really little, I was trying to learn how to bake bread, and my dad asked the bakers if we could have like a little chunk of their sourdough starter. And obviously they couldn't give us that, but like I was only like 7 or 8, so I started crying, and to get me to stop crying, they went ahead and gave me a little baby turtle back then for free. And I saved that baby turtle because I thought it was like the cutest thing ever. And it actually ended up like drying out, and then we kept it in the house for like 5 or 6 years afterwards until my mom accidentally knocked it off the counter. The leg broke off. So I thought I would get another little baby turtle to reminisce. I'll probably go ahead and eat this one, but memories.
Another beautiful day in San Francisco.
One of my absolute favorite things about San Francisco so far has been the number of cutesy little bookstores and bookshops that there have been.
I know that there's like a decent amount in Vancouver, but I honestly just like haven't really explored them that much because there's an Indigo really close to my apartment. I feel like these little like mom and pop type bookstores have so much personality. They're so cute and they're so quaint, and they just really add to the like the vibe and the aesthetic and the romanticism of reading good books. I wanted to show off some of the books that I've bought while I'm here. This one is Love Poems by Pablo Neruda. I don't think I'm pronouncing that correctly. This is like one of the most romantic poem books I've ever read. 10 out of 10 recommend if you're into that. I got West Portal by Benjamin Gucciardi. I also don't think that I'm pronouncing that correctly. It's very thought-provoking, and it's very like emotionally tumultuous, like, so I would recommend this one as well. I'm going to be reading this with one of my friends, Three and Science of Bisexuality by Julia Shaw. I think my friend and I have both been really interested in our sexualities and where it necessarily like where it coincides on the spectrum and difference between bisexuality and pansexuality and all that kind of stuff, and she and I have had a lot of conversations about it, but I don't think either of us have really read like a formative book on it. So I'm excited to give this a read. I actually got this book in New York, but I didn't show it off yet, so I'll show it off now. This is Color Scheme by Edith Young. This has been so interesting. Mainly while I was in New York, I was spending a lot of time trying to become more thoughtful when it comes to purchasing things, and specifically things for the home, and then clothing. So I definitely want to become more mindful of that, and this color scheme book has actually been really helpful in doing that and curating that and like being more considerate of that, because you don't really think about how much color impacts what you're purchasing and how you're living your life until you actually start to like think about it and like typology and color theory and all that kind of things, particularly when deciding like what color looks best on you or what color you're most comfortable in and like what makes your home happiest and the color that you want to surround yourself with, and whether those are like neutrals or like a warm yellow or a cozy pink or anything like that. It's just like I feel like they do a really interesting job of breaking it down in this book, even though this isn't the point of this book. It's not to like help with interior decorating or finding your personal style. This book has just like helped me consider more things and become more mindful in those facets of my life that I was already trying to consider and fix up. So I recommend this a lot. I think this is so interesting. And then the last thing that I got, this one was from SF, is My Higa Home. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it. But the way the author describes like how to curate a cozy home without like cluttering your space and what cozy can potentially mean to different people, I think that's all super insightful. I feel like recently I've gotten back into reading, which was like a totally lost art for me because I gave up reading after high school and I only ever read like required readings for school for like 5 or 6 straight years. But recently I've gotten back into just reading for enjoyment, and it's been really therapeutic. It's been really nice. And so I definitely want to keep doing this and exploring new little pockets of a city with regards to like their bookstores, and the personalities that come with them and the history and stuff has also been really fun. So I'm glad that I'm kind of diving into this book wormhole that book talk has spread so far and wide for so many young women.
Like this idea.
Oh my God.
I'm getting progressively worse at filming videos, but I'm finally back home from SF. I am finally going back to work tomorrow, which I'm actually pretty excited about. I've missed my friends from work, and I've missed working. I've missed the productivity and fulfillment that my job brings me, so it was overall just really, really nice. I feel like I've never been spoiled in this capacity by anyone other than family before, and I just feel so grateful for the friends and the people that I've met recently. I feel so grateful and so revitalized and healed, and it'll be hard to get back into the swing of things. I'm sad because vacation's over, but I also like can't stop smiling. I just feel like life is really treating me very well right now, and I can't be more thankful for that.